BJJ enters an empty, unfortunate-looking theatre, mostly, if not completely, naked. He holds a remote control and surveys the audience for a moment before speaking.
Hi, everyone. I'm a black playwright. I don't know exactly what that means, but I'm here to tell you a story. Let's find a way to help you deal with your low-grade depression, my therapist recently said to me. Okay. What makes you happy? I don't know. Really? Nothing makes you happy? Not really. What about work? Doesn't the theater make you happy? I mean, some of it, not all of it. So you're not excited about your work? I mean, I'm not excited. Do you have any career goals? No. Anyone's career you admire? Any professional role models? In the theater? Yeah. Are there any playwrights you admire? Anyone? I don't know. Just say the first name that comes to mind. Dion Boucicault. Who's that? He's a playwright. He's dead. He wrote in the 19th century. I've never heard of him. Yeah, no one cares about him anymore. He's dead. So your role model is someone no one cares about? I mean, people cared about him when he was alive. Oh, okay. And what did he write? Well, he's probably best known for writing this play called The Octoroon. The Octoroon? What's an octoroon? It's a person who's 1/8 black. Ah. And you like this play? Yeah? Okay. Well, here's an idea. Why don't you try adapting this octoroon for fun? I think it's important to reconnect with things you have felt or feel positive feelings for. So I did. Or I tried to. But then all the white guys quit. And then I couldn't find any more white guys to play any of the white guy parts because they all thought it was too melodramatic. I went back to my therapist and she was all like, "Do you think that maybe you're angry at white people?" What? I said, "Do you think that maybe you're angry at white people?" And I was like, I don't think so. Like, subconsciously. No. Like, most of my friends are white. Then my therapist was like, "Are you sure?" "Yeah, I'm literally surrounded by white people all the time." "Are you really, really sure, though? Like, 100% sure?" I looked at my therapist, who was white. "Well, who needs white guys?" she said nervously. "Do you really need them? Why can't you just play the parts?" "Me?" "Yeah. Isn't colorblind casting a thing? And isn't it how the theater started for you as an actor? Maybe it's worth going back to the source of your relationship with this thing you do." "Okay. So why don't you try playing the parts you need? Maybe you'll learn something from it." "Like what?" "I don't know. Whatever it is you learn from the theater. Sympathy? Compassion? Understanding?"
BJJ presses a button on his remote control, and loud, crude, bass-heavy, hyper-masculine rap music plays. BJJ retrieves a vanity table and folding chair from somewhere and starts setting up his makeup station, but then remembers something.
"Just kidding. I don't have a therapist. I can't afford one. You people are my therapy."
BJJ unpauses the music again and it plays as he finishes setting up his makeup station. Then he finds a bottle of wine or some other alcohol in a drawer, opens it and chugs the entire thing. The alcohol has no visible effect on him now or ever. Then BJJ gets into whiteface, possibly tries to cover his entire body with it. This should go on for some time. After he is satisfied, he slowly turns around and, without taking his eyes off the audience, very, very slowly and very, very stoically, gives himself a powerful wedgie. He takes the remote and turns the music down to underscoring. During the following, he continues getting into makeup, touching up, finessing.
"I believe an important part of being a good artist is recognizing your limits. So I can respect the pussies who pussy out of a project. I respect it when they get their people to be all like, well, such and such doesn't really get the part about the slaves. And I'm like, what is there not to get? It's slavery. And I'm not even asking you to play the slaves. You're playing the goddamn slave owner. I mean, God forbid you ask a black guy to play some football-playing, illiterate, drug addict, magical Negro Iraq vet with PTSD who's secretly on the DL with HIV, but who's also trying to get out of the generic ghetto with his pregnant obese girlfriend who has anger management issues from a history of sexual abuse. In fact, everyone's been sexually abused, and someone's mother has a monologue where she's snorting out of her nose and crying everywhere because she's been caught smoking crack and fired from a job as a hotel maid. I just made that up. Dibs. God forbid any actor of color not jump at the chance to play an offensive bag of garbage so far from his own life, but which some idiotic critic or marketing intern is going to describe as a gritty, truthful portrayal of the black experience in America. But the minute you ask a white guy to play a racist whose racism is complicated by some monologue where he's like, I don't mean to be racist, it's just complicated, he doesn't return your phone calls. Then my therapist was like, don't you think you ought to not shit where you eat? Well, what happens if I shit where I starve?
Playwright enters, also mostly, if not completely, naked, and stands in the back and listens.
Black playwright? I can't even wipe my own ass without someone trying to accuse me of deconstructing the race problem in America. I even tried writing about farm animals once, just to avoid talking about people. And this literary manager was like,
oh my god, you're totally deconstructing African folktales, aren't you? And I'm like, no, I'm just writing about farm animals. And she's like, no, no, you're totally deconstructing the African folktales. That's totally what you're doing.
And I was like, bitch, I'm not fucking deconstructing any fucking African folktales. I'm writing a fucking play about my issues with substance abuse, and then I'm attributing the dialogue to a fucking fox and a fucking rabbit to protect identities. So fuck you and give me a fucking break. And by break, I mean a fucking production.
BJJ puts a blonde wig on, the final touch. If the music hasn't ended now, BJJ pauses it.
So then my therapist asked me about my dreams. And I told her about this dream I had recently. A dream I keep having. Basically, I'm being attacked by a swarm of bees. I'm covered in bees. Bees are all over me, all over my arms, my legs, my chest. All over my neck, all over my face, in my eyes, and I can't see a thing. And I don't know if you know this, but the majority of deaths resulting from bee swarms aren't from bee stings, but actually from suffocation. Basically, bees have evolved to locate your breath and they follow it to your face, where some of them cover your eyes to blind you, and the others climb inside your nostrils and your mouth, causing you to choke to death. It's all very organized. But anyway, in my dream, it occurs to me that I need to figure out something to do before the bees asphyxiate me. And I start to panic. Every time. And it occurs to me I should call out for help. So I start screaming and I'm like, somebody help! Help, 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 somebody help! And then, every time I realize that I'm screaming, and that if I were actually suffocating, I wouldn't be able to scream. So I must not be suffocating. The bees aren't suffocating me. And every time when I reach this exact point where I realize this, the bees dissipate, they fly away. And the point of view changes to that angle in your dreams where you sometimes see yourself, and I could see that what looked like a swarm of bees attacking me was actually a swarm of bees that had come together for a brief moment into the shape of me being attacked by a swarm of bees, and it suddenly dawns on me, sadly, that I wasn't being attacked by the bees. I was the bees. And when they dissipate and fly away, they leave nothing behind. In other words, I was nothing. So my therapist goes, well, you know, that's interesting because the ancient Greeks believed that a swarm of bees was actually a sign that Dionysus was present. You know, Dionysus, the Greek god of... And I'm like, yes, bitch, thank you. I know who Dionysus is. I'm a playwright. Black playwright. Fuck you.